Two straight men are planning to marry, all so they can avoid paying inheritance tax. The two pensioners, who have been pals for almost 30 years, already live together and have now decided to tie the knot to avoid a massive tax bill. Michael O'Sullivan has already decided he wants to leave his Dublin home to his best pal, 85-year-old Michael, who is his carer. And now, the pair have decided to marry in Cashel, Cote d'Ivoire, so Michael will not be stung by a massive inheritance tax bill after Matt dies. Asked about his wedding plans, Matt, a lifelong bachelor, said, "Yes. No, he's not my partner, he's my best friend. He'll be part of my life when I die. And whatever I have, I'd give my home, there'll be no problems. He can have it." Speaking on RT and EQ's Liveline today, Michael, who was previously married and has two children with a second woman Eileen, added, "The thing is, I know Matt for 29 years, the same age as my own daughter. He lives in the same area as I grew up, in Stony Batter. And he's one of the nicest people anyone will ever meet in their life." Asked why they are getting married, Michael said, "What happened was Matt said to me, 'I'm going to leave you the house.' And I said, 'That's a nice idea, but because of tax reasons I'd have to pay half of that to the government, in capital acquisitions tax. I investigated it because I had another friend who got a €400,000 house in about 2008 from an aunt. The thing was, she left it and didn't know what to do with it and was just going to sell it. And eventually the crash came and the house fell below the value of €200,000. But when they came after her for tax, they said, 'No, no, when you got the house it was worth €400,000. Asked what the difference is when he and Matt get married, Michael told the Irish Mirror, "I'm a spouse then. The tax doesn't go to a spouse. If it's a husband or wife or two partners, if one dies, the house automatically goes to the partner." Asked about his kids and if he'd told them, Michael replied, "I have three wonderful children. I did tell them. The kids know Matt a long time. The only person I was a little bit worried about was Rachel. She was thinking about the green card over in America, where you marry someone for a green card and then you're old. You can't do that. It's against the law to do it for that reason. Rachel was my first, she's my ex-wife, and I have two children with another lovely woman called Eileen." Asked if he loved Matt, Michael said, "I love Matt, but not in a sexual way. I know him so long and I'm his carer now. The thing is, if I get left the house, as I say, a friend of mine who lost the house, as I say, the same thing could happen to me, another crash could come and then I'll be left with a burden around my neck." The friends were planning to tie the knot on December 22nd, but because of concerns over the weather conditions, the nuptials may be postponed until January.